Welcome back to Let's Play Vampire, the Masquerade Bloodlines Blind. We're in, I guess, our apartment. Got a boombox here.
Hello, L.A. You're up way past your bedtime, aren't you? Hope you've slipped into something comfortable. I know I have. If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to The Dead of Night. The only girl who will spend the night with you and leave first thing in the morning, guaranteed. Well, looks like the boards are lighting up. Aren't I the popular one? Let's see.
Blood pack.
Meeny, meeny, miny, moo. Who will be the lucky caller? You've got the first shot at Deb tonight. So, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Hi, Deb. This is, Vigo.
Vigo? So, Vigo, why are you up so late?
I'm working a late shift here at the yacht club.
Uh-huh. How many boats do you own, Vigo?
Actually, three. One is in the shop.
I used to do a little yachting myself. What brand of yacht do you have?
You probably wouldn't know the brand.
Akuna Coil.
Bought them in Italy.
Ah, la Italia bella. Parlate italiano?
Yes.
Arrivederci, Vigo.
Just open.
Hello, caller.
I am.
Is tonight a rerun?
Deb.
Caller number three, what's keeping you up tonight?
Deb, listen to me, Deb. They're at it again and people have got to know. They've got to know because they don't know. They won't report this stuff on the news because they own the news.
Hello, Gomez. What's the latest conspiracy?
Conspiracy? This goes beyond conspiracy, okay? There's no word for something as devious and secret as this, you understand? People need to hear this. They need to know the real story.
You've got our undivided attention.
All right. As we all know, the Americans established a moon base back in the late 70s. That's no secret. But what most people don't know is that they have been conducting a dig. Not for resources, but for artifacts.
I see.
Well, it's no coincidence that the Chinese have started conducting space missions. You know why? I'll tell you why. The reason is because the Chinese are trying to stop the Americans from finding an ancient space probe sent by the Beta Centaurians. And why? Because the Beta Centaurians are giving space technology to the Chinese to get back at the Andromedans, a.k.a. the Greys. For giving space technology to the Americans in the 50s.
Fascinating.
The American government's been putting more money into space. Don't you see what's happening? I can't believe I'm the only one that's figured it out. Am I the only person alive that can see what's going on? It's because the Andromedans and the Betas are going to be fighting their war in this galaxy through us, Deb. And the American people, the people of Earth, you people, cannot let this happen. It's Moon versus Atlantis all over again.
Thank you, Gomez. And that concludes the news portion of the show. Well, this girl's got to pay her bills, so it's time for a few commercials. But don't go anywhere. I'm just getting warmed up. Should I say, hot?
Friggin' Chicken recently challenged several random people to a taste test between Friggin' Chicken
and the other
leading chicken-flavored products. Let's listen for which one they preferred.
Ma'am, care to participate in a taste test? Here, try this leading brand of chicken.
Oh my gosh! Is that week-old fish?
Now, try this.
Oh! This is some good chicken! What is this?
Sir, take a test for me?
Sure. Seriously, drop these up your
here, try this one.
Motherfucking great chicken right there. What is this?
It's friggin' chicken.
This is cat, right? Are you feeding me cat?
Try this.
Holy fuck. Fuck, that's good. What the fuck is this shit?
9 out of 10 people preferred friggin' chicken over the competition. Why?
Cause that's some good friggin' chicken. I mean, friggin' chicken.
Friggin' chicken, you'll swear it's the best you've ever had. You love the talking baby movie, and the talking pig, and even the talking car in that show. You know the one I'm talking about. But now prepare for the most hilarious, talkingest, normally mute object yet. He's Steve Cash, a New York banker and recent whittler down on his luck.
And 10 makes 100. Here's your money, ma'am.
Ma'am, I happen to have a glandular problem. That's it. I'm withdrawing all my millions from this bank.
Cash!
She's an ATM machine with the soul of his dead wife.
There's something familiar about this ATM machine.
I love you.
Wow, those marketing guys are geniuses.
Together, they're learning to make the most of their special situation.
So that girl from accounting used me today.
Really?
She wasn't like everybody else. When she pushed my buttons, she was very gentle.
Oh, honey,
oh, brother.
If you don't stop, I'm gonna have to make a deposit.
Transferring cash. Wednesdays at 8:30 in the BMC. Say goodbye to yellow teeth and spots.
How long does this go on for?
It's incredible.
Look at that shine.
Your smile or these dinner plates?
Harnessing the secrets of ancient Egypt, now there's a dishwashing detergent so powerful, it doesn't just leave your dishes spotless, it actually whitens your teeth. Patented time-release spirit toys remove caked-on food and grease and remain on the plate to be absorbed into your food to clean your teeth while you eat. Dazitron, the dishwashing detergent of the future for cleaner plates and whiter teeth. Last year, Democratic candidate Michael Redmond bought a sports utility vehicle. 3 months later, there were two separate incidences of hit and runs by an unidentified SUV in his area. Is Democratic candidate Michael Redmond to blame? Can you afford to take that chance?
I don't know.
Children? Vote Republican Senator Robert Thorne, a candidate that has never committed vehicular homicide. Democratic candidate Michael Redmond has never publicly stated his opinion on child pornography.
Oh, brother.
Because he's hiding something. Would you want a child pornographer voting on this nation's laws? Could you trust your children's future to someone like that? Vote Republican Senator Robert Thorne, the candidate that has committed...
Well, they'd probably be safe in the future.
Democratic candidate Michael Redmond recently sued Senator Robert Thorne for accusing Redmond of being a murderous child pornographer. But Redmond had previously said he was against clogging up courts with frivolous lawsuits. Wouldn't this make him a hypocrite? Would you want a hypocrite as your next congressman? Or would you want your children to become hypocrites? Vote Republican Senator Robert Thorne, a candidate not accused of being a murderous child pornographer.
In a world where in a world live and die.
Do you think you could just go in there and handle this by yourself?
If that's what it takes. He was about to meet his greatest foe.
Kill them all! All of them!
And a girl.
Hello.
Hi.
And a comic relief sidekick who won't make it to Act 3.
I picked the wrong month to cancel my life insurance.
No, don't say that. You're gonna make it.
With a guy from that other movie that was slightly popular, and what's her name, from that show you sometimes watch. In a movie with two spectacular CGI battle sequences and an advertising campaign that will leave you no choice but to see this film. See it, because it's a movie, and all your friends are going. In theaters Friday,
basically.
And on DVD in 3 months.
Describes
Hello,
many
LA.
Movies.
You're up way past your bedtime, aren't you? Hope you've slipped into something comfortable. I know I have. If you're new to town or just new to this radio thing, you're listening to The Dead of Night. The only girl who will spend the night with you and leave first thing in the morning, guaranteed. Well, looks like the boards are lighting up. Aren't I the popular one? Let's see. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
Same caller.
The lucky caller, you've got the first shot at Deb tonight. So, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Hi, Deb. This is, Vigo.
Vigo? So, Vigo, why are you up so late?
To go with the yacht?
I'm working a late shift here at the, yacht club.
Yeah, okay.
How many boats?
Hope that wasn't too boring. Well, I can turn this off. And now we can watch TV instead.
Rivers' agent released a statement stating that Rivers' crash was due to a mechanical problem and that the studio is not pursuing legal action against Rivers for the trademark and its destruction. Miraculously, this is the second crash Rivers has escaped unharmed in the last year. Our top story tonight, a derelict ship found floating 10 miles off the Los Angeles coast earlier this morning was towed into the port of Los Angeles a few hours ago. The ship was spotted around midnight by fishermen who contacted the Coast Guard after their attempts to hail the ship proved futile. Coast Guard officials are releasing very little information right now, but have identified the vessel as the Elizabeth Dane. No word as to the whereabouts of the crew, though the Coast Guard are asking any ships that had contact with the Elizabeth Dane to assist them in their search. We'll have more on this story as it breaks. In other news, an apparent third victim of the Southland slasher has prompted the closing of the Santa Monica Pier, where the body was found earlier tonight. Investigators say the scene closely mirrors those of slayings in Glendale and Long Beach.
Kindred.
In both cases, the bodies of the victims were described as torn apart, though details are being withheld from the public at this time. Police urge anyone with information relating to this case to contact them. Actor Ash Rivers is lucky to be alive after his car crashed into the gate at Parasite Studios earlier tonight. Witnesses say that they were shocked when the Negative Zero star emerged unscathed and apparently unfazed by his high-speed accident. Rivers' agent released a statement stating that Rivers' crash was due to a mechanical problem and that the studio is not pursuing legal action against Rivers for the trademark gate's destruction. Miraculously, this is the second crash Rivers has escaped unharmed in the last year.
He's Kindred.
Our top story tonight, a derelict ship found floating 10 miles off the Los Angeles coast earlier this morning was towed into the port of Los Angeles a few hours ago. The ship was spotted around midnight by fishermen who contacted the coast.
All right, what else we got? Hey, the password for your computer is Sunrise. Please keep the cash in a drawer. It's yours. I dropped you an email with my address. Come on over after you get settled. Mercurio. I got cash. Give me the cash. $100. An envelope containing a bit of cash. Okay, so this... got three blood packs. A bag of blood routinely used in hospitals for transfusions. Using it restores blood points. Pretty sweet. Now, I could technically do that now, because we don't have that much blood, but... might as well save it when we really need it. Maybe I can find someone outside to feed on instead in some alley or something like that. At your convenience, please come and visit me in my home downtown. I leave you this to guide you. Dark blood our curse. Alight this verse. Such power I sense in one so young. Come find me where burns the mystical sun. M. Strauss, Tremere Regent. Okay, cool. I get to meet the leader of the Tremere, or one of the leaders. Come find me where burns... okay, some kind of mystical, magical sun or something. All right. M. Strauss, the Tremere Regent, has invited you to his home in downtown Los Angeles. You will need to find him. You need to find him. His invitation left a cryptic riddle which reads, yeah, and then Prince LaCroix has dictated that you are to meet with an agent of his named Mercurio in Santa Monica, who will provide you with the details of your assignment. Jihad for beginners. You have survived the Sabbat assault. I got a computer. LaCroix Foundation. Secure Internet. You have 5 emails. 5 are unread. Home menu. You know, even back in when this game came out, computers weren't like this. Type menu or command. Well, this is menu. So, just out of curiosity. What does help say? Type list. It's the same thing as we saw back in that other computer terminal or laptop or whatever. That's pretty cool. It's your first 7 of your character name at home. Alright, email. Alright, what was it again? Something about sun? Should we hack into our own? Let's hack into our own. Skill too low to make a hack attempt at difficulty 5. Interesting. I forgot what it was. Here. Sunrise. There was something about sun. Oh. Can we open any other drawers while I'm messing around outside here? No. Sunrise. Entering email. Email for Suckhead. What? A reminder. From LaCroix. Mercurio will contact you when you arrive in Santa Monica. Waste no time in meeting with him. SL. Subject, dang, it's big, you know. 1111 hung low at trojanbotnet.vtm. That was legit. Penis enlargement. Watch the girls come running. Call today. 1-800-555-STICK. Even vampires can't avoid spam, right? Kilpatrick's Crime Pewter from Arthur at dirtcheapinternet.vtm. Looking for that lazy-ass ex-husband who's late on his alimony payments? How about that jerk who knocked you up? Look no further. With Arthur Kilpatrick's amazing crime pewter, you can find almost anyone with a record, and these days that's just about everyone. So come on down to Arthur Kilpatrick's bail bonds. If you've got the deadbeat, we've got the technology to find him. Welcome, from Mercurio. Hey, welcome to town. Come on over to my place once you get situated, and we'll see about what you'll need to get the job done. I'm going to pick up explosives right now, some astrolite. I should be back by the time you come over. I'm at 24 Main Street in number 4. Walk to the end of the alley, and my building is the next one on the right. I'm assuming that's going to be in my quest log. I'm going to write it down anyway. Number 4. 24 Main. Okay, done. Next. The opening from a friend. The game begins. A pawn is moved. Okay. Okay. That's it? Nothing else to see? Nothing else to see here? Move along. All that stuff. So these oh, wait. Oh! Oh my god. Holy crap, what? But there's nothing in there. I didn't realize I could move that. Well, I guess that's it. It wouldn't let me stand up. Okay. Oh, bathroom. Yep, I got no... Oh, there's no mirror. I was gonna say I have no reflection because I'm a vampire. We got a pill bottle. Estrogen? Caution, do not take if male. I can't use it. I can move stuff around like that. Looks like you've got a wallet set for a night on the town. Alright. Oh, no, we can use that for. Maybe someone will need it at some point. Hmm. A normal watch. As opposed to a special watch? This is a replica of a much nicer watch. Well, maybe some people will want this stuff and we'll get a reward or something for using it. Giving it to them? I don't know. We just moved ourselves out of the room. Okay. Now save. Failed. Lock difficulty 5. The LA Sun. Carnival of Death. Gruesome remains found on the pier. Police baffled. Gruesome remains were found on the Santa Monica Pier. Perhaps we should look into this. Picking up more and more quests here. This is lockpicking into people's places. Succeeded. Place is empty. I thought I might have set off some kind of alarm that was outside. Like, who has an alarm in a place like this? There are hotel rooms? Or is this a bunch of flats? I can't hack into this one? So I can't interact with anything here. How disappointing. There's none of these. All the mirrors are broken. I mean, I know I probably couldn't see my reflection anyway, right? Or is that just in the movies? There's nothing at all in here. Alright. I wonder if I get experience for successfully picking locks. I guess that's mine. No item. Violating the masquerade by revealing aspects of supernatural existence to humankind put you at risk of ambush by human vampire hunters.
Hey, lady. You got some change, lady?
I could regain some humanity, maybe, by giving him some change. Oh, brother. Number three. Choosers can't eat beggars. I want to keep my humanity up if possible. Here, it's not much, but I hope it helps.
That's very nice. Thank you.
I only gave him 10. That's good. Humanity gained. I was right. Now, I can feed on him. As long as I don't kill him, I won't lose humanity. He's going to drain rather quickly, though. That's the thing.
Hey, lady, thanks a lot.
Don't mention it. I mean, don't mention it. Payment rendered. What's going on over here?
Yes, is there something I can, help you with?
What are you doing?
Waiting for that blasted tow truck I called an hour ago. I'd rather not wait another second in this part of town, this time of night. It's a rather dreadful place, don't you think? I should have listened to my mechanic, by German, he said.
It's dreadful, Levy. My wallet's been stolen. Green is intimidation. Now, if I intimidate him into giving him me money, do I then lose humanity? Because I was surprised when I lost humanity in that last episode. By telling the security guard to lead the way, and he ended up getting attacked, I think killed, and... But I didn't know. I didn't know that was gonna happen. I guess I should have figured, Think you could spare me a few bucks? I'm a little down on my luck right now.
Sure. I guess I could spare a few dollars. Here you are. Good luck getting back on your feet.
Thank you. So we lost $10 and gained 20. You know, that sure is a nice watch you've got.
My watch? It's a quantum limited edition. Only 50 made in the world. Quite irreplaceable. It was an anniversary present for my wife.
I'll be nice. You have a nice night. I'm gonna go tell people what time it is. Well, we need to just explore everywhere, don't we? And talk to everyone. Ooh, the tattoo parlor. Devil's Brand Tattoo. Professional brand. Professional body piercing.
Hey. Starting.
They don't speak.
Hey! How's it going, girl?
I'm okay. Do I know you?
Oh, man! Wait! Say that again!
Okay. Okay, do I know you?
Oh man, you! You're a vampire, aren't you?
What? That's pretty much my reaction at number one. What? Vampire? What the hell are you smoking?
Come on, you are too! Oh man, don't bullshit me, girl. Just come clean. I ain't gonna tell no one. It's okay. I just wanna talk.
What does this guy know? And how? He's on to us, apparently. Alright then, let's talk.
Hell yeah! Oh man! I knew it! I knew you were! I just could tell!
What?
It was great! And then I saw your teeth and I was like, damn, it was like I could just sense you. The name's Knox Harrington. Pleasure to meet you. Oh man!
I don't know if we should admit to it. The pleasure's all yours. Leave me alone, jackass.
Hey, chick! Just because I'm a ghoul and you're some cool vampire, you don't need to treat me like crap, okay? Oh, man, you make me so mad!
Just shut up and tell me what a ghoul is.
Okay, calm down. Don't be such a bitch! Well, the way it was explained to me, whenever a vampire lets a human drink some of their vampire blood, the human gains a little vampire power. Can heal up quick and that kind of stuff. Jeez, oh man. And they're a ghoul and ooh, watch out.
Huh. This guy definitely seems to know something. Isn't that the guy from the alley outside? But if we're talking out here in the open, are these people going to hear us? Would that violate the masquerade? Who was the vampire that made you a ghoul?
Oh man! I really wish I could tell you, but I don't think I'm supposed to. But it's really cool to be talking to you just, well, because I don't get a lot of chance to talk to vampires. Oh man! Well, other than my master. So I thought I'd just say, you know, what's up? You know?
You like being a ghoul?
It's awesome! Man, after that first taste of vampire blood, it's like the best drug. Oh, man, I'm telling you, it's like, well, it didn't mess me up. It just made me feel like I was better at everything. I felt like a god just sucking on that nasty dude's wrist.
So what are you doing around here?
Look, I probably shouldn't tell you this, but I'm on a secret mission for my master. Well, hey, it's been great talking to you, man. But I better be going. Oh, man, you know, important stuff to do.
See you around.
No.
Hey, no.
No, no.
What's up, girl?
Can I ask you some questions?
Oh, man. man, yeah, sure. What do you want to know?
Is there anything I should know about Santa Monica?
Oh, yeah, here's something. There's a blood bank in the basement of this medical clinic here. That can come in mighty handy for vampires. You know what I mean?
I just noticed a little insignia or whatever on his jacket. Can I ask you some more questions?
Oh, man, yeah, sure. What do you want to know?
Is he going to say something different? Anything else I should know about Santa Monica?
Oh, yeah, here's something. There's a blood bank in the basement.
Okay.
Oh, man, yeah.
How do I get to the beach from here?
Just go down to the end of the street. Make a left into the parking garage, take the steps down, and the tunnel will lead you right out into the beach.
Thanks. Bye. I did increase the audio a little, but I think it needs to be increased a little bit more. I just don't want it to be over. I was here, right? But the intro might have been louder than everything else. So now we're here, so 80%. I just don't want my voice to be too much louder than the voices, but still, I don't want them to drown me out either. You can go in there. Tattoo place. Is this? This is nothing, right? Okay. Glad I got my blood up a little bit. Blood levels. I'm gonna turn. Oh, it's locked.
Hey, buddy, go your own way.
I beg your pardon. High intimidate feat will give you special dialogue options. These will be displayed in green text. Certain characters can be more easily intimidated than others. Oh, what is this? Police station or something?
I don't speak English.
I don't speak English? You spoke three words in English.
I don't think so.
Mm-hmm. I have to use the bathroom. So maybe a hospital? A clinic?
If you think you might die, raise your hand.
I don't think I'm gonna die.
Please, wait your turn and you'll be seen.
Red is domination. That uses one blood. And then I've got blue, which is persuasion. I don't really have a lot or anything in that.
I'll not be seen, nor will I wait.
All right, go on back. Try not to get any blood on your paperwork.
No, I get the blood in my mouth. Thank you very much. I don't know why we need to go back.
So, buddy.
But we're gonna go back.
What's the haps, bro?
Haps?
Don't touch me, right?
Ooh. Beg your pardon? Can I look through your filing?
Anyone?
Cabinets. Room number one. What is this?
Please get a doctor.
Okay. I'll see what I can do.
My insides, it hurts so bad.
Alright. Let me get a doctor. Where is a doctor? You a doctor.
What time is it? I'm sorry, miss, but you're going to have to wait outside like everyone else. No exceptions.
But there's this girl over there, and I think she's going to die.
See here now, I'm the only physician here at the moment. We got twice as many people as usual waiting for treatment. I'll look at her as soon as possible. Try to talk to her. Keep her awake.
Dominate. I don't have the option, but...
I've got a man in there with a bullet in his head. My nurse paged Dr. Roberts a half hour ago. He'd be here any time. Till then, stay with your friend and make sure she doesn't go into shock. I must go.
No dominate option? Damn you, okay.
If I could only rest for a second.
Well, if anything, we'll get some humanity back, I'm sure. Excuse me.
Can someone call my grandma, please?
Stay with me. I can save you. Love your hair. Is that how you spell that? I'm afraid if I say sorry I can't help you, I'm afraid that she's gonna die. But I'm not sure if we're supposed to do that. When we get in trouble with Prince Lacroix, maybe my blood can save you. I'm a newbie. I didn't know any better. I guess I'm, like, dominating her into doing this. Now she's a ghoul. Tastes good? She looks happy. Humanity gained. Okay. Oh, I got one experience. I might be able to put something into a point, depending on whether they cost 3 or 4. Quest complete and... Okay. Got a lot of stuff going on. You alright?
You... Who are you? Oh... What did you do? What did you do to me?
I simply wanted to help.
But you did something. I kissed your wrist.
Sorta.
I can feel it inside of me. What did you do?
Should we tell the truth? Should we come clean? Look, forget about this. And don't say anything. You'll be fine.
You. I feel like I know you. Like you've always been here.
Fine. I'm a vampire. My blood healed you.
What? Doctor! Security!
No.